Hi there, it's Gabriele here from pilotclimb.com, and in today's video we're gonna talk about the IFR training. IFR means Instrument Flight Rules. This is a review of a blog post that I posted today on pilotclimb.com. By the end of this video you will learn what does IFR mean, what are the differences between IFR and VFR, what is IMC and VMC, and why IFR is important. So without further ado, let's dive into it. So what does IFR mean? The acronym IFR means Instrument Flight Rules, and these are rules that are set and we need to comply with when we fly looking at instrumentations, because we have to understand that there are two main rules categories, that one is VFR and the other one is IFR. VFR has to be followed, the rules of visual flight rules has to be followed whenever we fly visually, whenever the pilot look outside and take as a reference is the outside terrain or cities, lakes and so on. But whenever there are certain conditions that don't allow us to fly under the VFR rules, the visual flight rules, we need to fly IFR and follow the instrument flight rules. That means that whenever we fly looking at instrumentations, we need to follow and comply with the IFR. Which are these sort of conditions that doesn't allow us to fly under visual flight rules? You can imagine, let's say today we've got low visibility, fog around clouds, and that means that we cannot look outside, so we cannot base our position by looking outside and know where we are. So in this case we need to fly following the instrument flight rules. That is because whenever you are inside a cloud or fog, for a pilot it's extreme, it's practically impossible to fly looking outside, because inside a cloud, and I can tell you that when you're inside a cloud you don't have references, so the only thing that you see is an aircraft that is stopped, that you will feel that the aircraft is not moving, and sometimes the instrumentation tells you something completely different and opposite compared to what you are feeling. It happens to me during my flight training that I was feeling that I was turning left or right, and the instrumentations were telling me that I was actually going straight, or vice versa. The instrumentation were telling me that I was turning left or right, but I was feeling I was going straight. In this case, it's paramount that as a pilot, whenever you're inside a cloud, you trust your instrumentation 100%. And whenever you are inside a cloud, that means you are doing IFR flights, and that means that you are IFR certified. That's why, in order to fly under the IFR, the airplane and the pilot needs to be certified. Almost every commercial air transport operations aircraft flies under IFR, and that's because under IFR, we have very specific routes to follow, from the takeoff all the way up to cruise, from the cruise all the way up to destination airport. In this way, because we've got very specific route to follow, made by degrees, made by distances, made by minimum altitudes, the air traffic controller can actually manage the traffic flow, because compared to the visual flight rules, the pilot that wants to go from A to B, the pilot himself can decide where to go, where to fly in order to get to the destination. He still, even during a VFR, he still has to comply with some waypoints, some position reports and so on, but he decides whether if he wants to go slightly more to the left, slightly more to the right, there is no problem. On the IFR, we really need to follow this specific standard route, and we cannot go outside them, because on the IFR commercial planes, we are flying quite fast, so if you do a mistake, you go too much to the right or left, you can get close to another aircraft under IFR that's following another standard route. So the next thing that we're going to talk about in today's video is the visual meteorological condition, also called VMC. I want to make sure that it's clear that we've got VMC and IMC. Okay, visual meteorological conditions are, VMC are the visual meteorological conditions that allows the pilot under to fly on VFR. Okay, so if you're a VFR pilot and you don't have the instrument flight rule rating, you're not certified to fly IFR, you can only fly under when you've got the visual meteorological conditions. An IFR pilot, however, even under the visual meteorological conditions, can fly either VFR or IFR. But, and this is very important to know, that when you are in an instrument meteorological condition, you can only fly under the IFR. So if you are a VFR pilot and that day we've got instrument meteorological condition, you have to stay on the ground. I'm very sorry about that. But what I made this table where, depending on each airspace classes, as you can see here from Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, Echo, Foster, and Golf, I made clear when you are in VMC, okay, so when you can fly VFR. And we have to understand here is only VMC, because if the conditions are lower than they described here in this table, we are automatically into IMC, so there is no need to say where we are in IMC. So, if we start from here, we've got airspace class Alpha, VFR are not allowed. So, if you are a VFR, you cannot fly in airspace class Alpha, so there is no need to talk about VMC, because only IFR planes can fly there. On the Bravo airspace, we are in VMC anytime we are above flight level 100, and we have 8 kilometers visibility minimum and clear of clouds. Whenever we fly below flight level 100, we are in VMC with 5 kilometers visibility minimum and clear of clouds. With the airspace category Charlie, Delta, Echo, and Foxtrot, we are in VMC when we fly above flight level 100 if we've got 8 kilometers visibility minimum and we have vertical separation from the cloud of 1000 feet and an horizontal separation of 1500 meters. Below flight level 100, we've got 5 kilometers visibility minimum and a vertical separation of 1000 feet and an horizontal separation of 1500. As you can see from this table here, they are pretty much the same above or below flight level 100. The only difference is that below flight level 100 is the visibility minimum is 5 kilometers and not 8 kilometers. For the airspace Golf, we have to have 5 kilometers visibility minimum, clear of cloud, and inside the terrain at all the time. Okay, so what I want to make sure that it's clear is that as a commercial pilot, okay, I'm a professional pilot. When I fly, I normally think that I'm in VMC or IMC, depending if I'm above or below these minimums, because I need to know if, when I'm going descending inbound my airport, if I could find some VFR traffic around. So let's say I'm flying, normally you find them in Germany where you've got a very nice green airport and a lot of VFR traffic, you can find them because we fly as well in Germany. I fly normally in Germany as small airports. So what happens is that maybe you're flying with a big fast airplane and you will find close. You will fly close to a VFR traffic. So you have to know where you are in VMC, and because you need to look outside more in order to make sure that you don't fly too close to this VFR traffic. If you are flying to the same small airport that normally is full of VFR traffic, but that day you are in IMC, so the visibility is below 5K or the vertical separation is, the cloud base is below 1000 feet, you know that all the VFR traffic will stay on the ground and you don't have to think about it. Okay, so normally this is the most important part of the chart, because normally the VFR traffic, they don't fly, they can fly above flight level 100, of course, and they do fly, but the biggest percentage of VFR traffic flies below flight level 100, normally in this category airspace. So as a rule of thumb, when I'm flying, I always think, okay, the visibility is below 5 kilometers, that means that I'm in IMC, I don't think about VFR traffic. If a nice day and visibility is above 5 kilometers and there is no cloud base, for example, and I'm flying to a small airport, then I have to think about VFR traffic, okay? So that's how I do it on the commercial operations. Anytime we are below the minimums that we described above, that means that we are in IMC operation. IMC operation, IFR traffic, normally commercial traffic flies around. And what I can tell you on there, when you really, I mean, because with 5 kilometers, it's not the greatest visibility, but it's still a good visibility. But IMC operations, when the real IMC operations, when you cannot really see outside, okay? Happens to me many times that I took off, I went into a cloud at 400-500 feet, and then I spent 3 hours into a cloud, I descend all the way down to the airport, and then I saw the airport at 200 feet, the destination airport at 200 feet. So I spent 97% of my flight into a cloud. So that's really real IMC operations, okay? So what happened when you're in MC operations compared to VMC operations? That on MC operations, you don't know, you cannot see where the terrain is visually, okay? Because if you look outside of your window, you only see white, okay? You don't feel anything, you don't feel the aircraft is moving, you just trust your instrumentations and you have to know where you are. That's very, it's paramount, because under MC operations, the terrain becomes the biggest threat because you cannot see outside, okay? In a nice and clear day, even if you're flying IFR, because IFR means that you have to follow your instrumentations for navigation purposes, but if the weather is good outside, you know, you have to look outside, okay? It's still important. It's very important, and I want to make sure that it's clear that even though you're flying IFR, you still have to look outside, okay? If then it's a nice day, okay? So it's very easy to see that the mountain is there, the other traffic is there, and so on. But on IMC conditions where you cannot see outside, you really need to take these informations from the inside instrumentations or from a third party. For example, an air traffic controller, you can ask him where the other traffics are, or for example, if you're not sure about some terrain, you can ask him to vector you to a better place, for example. So that's why on the EMC condition, you really need to think about where your terrain is, where is your aircraft compared to the terrain, and you really need to follow even more closely the standard route that you have to follow under IFR operations, okay? The good thing of all this is that all the air traffic controllers knows exactly the terrain of his area and knows exactly the position of the airport, of the airplane using the radar. So that means that if the air traffic controller sees that an airplane is going too close to a terrain, it can always advise the pilot. This happen, will happen, and that's the job of the air traffic controller, to control and instruct the pilots, and it's basically a teamwork, okay? So the pilot has to make sure that it flies correctly, but if something happens, the controller is there to monitor and to instruct him to fly a different heading if applicable and required, okay? One thing is very important to understand, that the final terrain responsibility is the captain one, okay? The captain has the final responsibility about terrain. Even though, let's say, the controller says, fly this heading for such a time, and then you get too close to the terrain, that's still the captain responsibility, even though the air traffic controller told you to fly a specific heading, because it's your responsibility as a captain to know where your aircraft is compared to the terrain, okay? So on the IFR operations and IMC conditions, the controller can give us a direct to, okay? So direct to, for example, you take off, and instead of following the standard route, as we said before, it tells you from present position, fly direct to a point. This has a multiple benefits, because allows us to fly a shorter distance and save fuel, for example. However, whenever you're in MC conditions flying IFR, you need to make sure that direct to are actually good direct to. What I mean by that is that even if the air traffic controller told you so, you need to make sure that if you turn left or right from your standard route that you know is clear of terrain, you need to make sure that this direct to is actually clear of terrain. In the departure charts, we've got lots of information about the terrain that's around us. Our navigation display tells us a lot of information about the terrain that's around us. So before accepting any direct to, take a few seconds and think about it, okay? Think, are we clear if we turn left? Yes. Are we clear if we turn left? No. So if the answer is no, just ask to continue with the standard routes, and the air traffic controller will really assist you with that. There is no problem, okay? All another thing that air traffic controller can provide to the pilot during IMC operations are called radar vectors. Radar vectors are mainly instructions from the air traffic controller to the pilot about flying a specific heading for a specific time, okay? So let's say you're flying a standard route, then due to traffic, for example, the controller tells you turn left heading, I don't know, 350, and then it will tell us when we can resume our navigation, standard navigations, okay? Again, this all air traffic controllers, is the air traffic controller work to control, to make sure that we've got a good flow of traffic, and it's a teamwork between the pilot and the controller, okay? So I want to make sure that it's clear what's the role of the air traffic controller as well into IMC operations. So the flight phases, okay, the flight phases of an IFR flight we need to make sure that it's clear that each phase of flight is well connected, okay? So when you fly IFR, we need to know that when you take off, you fly a specific route for departure until your cruise altitude, for example, and this departure is called SID, so Standard Instrumental Departure. Then, once we get to the cruise, level, normally, we have to fly another phase, and we go into the airway, which is called airway, and this is the en route phase of our flight. So once we are in cruise level, we fly into the airways. It's like a big corridor that is in the sky. We fly all the way down. We get close to our destination airport. So we need another procedure to leave the airway and get closer and start the descent, getting closer to our destination airport. And that is called STAR, or Standard Arrival. The standard arrival allows us to leave the airway and get close to the airport, but doesn't allow us to land. What happens is that the STAR will bring us from the airways all the way down to a point very close to the airport, and from that very close point to the airport, we join another procedure that's called approach procedure that allows us to fly from that point all the way down to the touchdown and land. So it's very important that we understand that all these procedures are connected by waypoints. In the next videos that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take each of these procedures, for example, SIDs, STARs, airways, approach procedures, and I'll go through these the charts on the pilot charts, and I'll show you how to read them, what kind of information you can find in there, and all the relative pieces of information that are required to know in order to fly IFR. So I hope you like the video. If you like, click the like button. If you have any question, just give me a comment below and then I'll be more than happy to answer. Subscribe to the channel and check pilotclimb.com, where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. Thank you very much for watching the video, and I'll see you on the next one.